The Constitution of India, Preamble. We, the people of India, having solemnly resolved to constitute India into a sovereign, socialist, secular, democratic republic and to secure to all its citizens justice, social, economic and political, liberty of thought, expression, belief, faith and worship, equality of status and of opportunity, and to promote among them all fraternity, assuring the dignity of the individual and the unity and integrity of the nation. In our Constituent Assembly, this 26th day of November 1949, do hereby adopt, enact and give to ourselves this Constitution.
Hello, welcome back to the social class. It's a long time since we met, isn't it? Yes. I hope all of you are preparing for your continuous evaluation, isn't it? Yes. Revise your chapters, call your subject teachers to clarify your doubts and be confident. Okay. Yes. In the last chapter, we discussed about Indian states, union territories, mountains, rivers, deserts, cities and towns, and also about the seasons in India. And today we are moving on to the next chapter, chapter 5, India, the land of diversities. What is the title of the new chapter? Yes, India, the land of diversities. So, children, take page number 87 in your studio. Chapter 5, India, a land of diversity. This lesson focuses on cultural diversity in India, then also the concept of unity in diversity. So, this chapter focuses on two main things: cultural diversity in India and also the concept of unity in diversity. Now open page number 88. Cultural India. What is unique about the Indian culture? Can you guess? Let's check. Here you can see a pep activity. Meet a group of 5 friends who like to travel and explore places across India. Solve the clues to find out which state each one comes from. You can use an atlas if needed. So, here is a group of 5 friends who like to travel and explore places across India. So, they have given some clues about their states. So let's find out their states. Okay. Yes. The first one, Aniket is from the northern part of India. He comes from the state whose capital is Lucknow. Which state is he from? Lucknow is the capital of, yes, Uttar Pradesh. So, Aniket is from Uttar Pradesh. The next one, Arjun comes from a union territory neighboring Tamil Nadu. Where is he from? Which is the union territory that neighboring Tamil Nadu? Pondicherry. So, Arjun is from Pondicherry. The next one, Gaurav comes from a state in the southern part of India that was formed out of Andhra Pradesh. Which state is he from? So Gaurav is from a state that come out of from Andhra Pradesh. So his state is, yes, the Telangana. The next one, Priyanka comes from a state in the northeastern part of India. The capital of this state is Dispur. Which state is she from? Dispur is the capital of? Yes, Assam. Dispur is the capital of Assam. So Priyanka is from Assam. Sonali's father runs a big textile factory in Surat. Which state is she from? Where is the place Surat? Yes, it is in Gujarat. It is in the state Gujarat. So Sonali is from Gujarat. So we have identified their states, isn't it? Yes. So you have done it really well. Very good. Now take page number 89. India is the 7th largest country in the world. So as we all studied earlier, India is the 7th largest country in the world. The country is divided into 28 states and 8 union territories. So there is one mistake. That's not a mistake. That is the old number of states and union territories. But now it is 28 states and 8 union territories. Each of these states has people following a different culture. So each of these states have their own culture. Do you know what is called culture? Let's see. Culture is a word that describes people's way of life. So culture is a word that describes or used to denote people's way of life. People's way of life in a particular place. That is what meant by culture. Okay. Yes. So culture is a word that describes people's way of life, their language, religion, food, social habits, music, art, clothes. So these all are factors that included in the culture or the way of life or the way of life of people in a particular area or a particular place or a particular state. Indian culture is rich and unique in its own way. So Indian culture is unique and different in its own way because there are 28 states in India. So just like there are 34 students in 4th standard. These 34 students are from 34 families. So they are from different family backgrounds, from different religion, from different cultures. So like that, India is divided into 28 states and these 28 states has their own culture, their own way of life. I think it's clear for you, isn't it? Yes. People in India speak different languages, dress differently, eat different kinds of food and follow different religions. So people in India use different languages to speak, to communicate. Like for example, in Kerala, we use Malayalam as our language or our mother tongue. And in Tamil Nadu, they use Tamil. And in North India, they use some other languages of their own. So these all things, this language, this dress or eating or food habits get vary from one state to another. So the way of life of people in a particular place is called as culture. I hope the concept culture is clear for you. Isn't it? Yes. So that's all for today. So let's explore some of these facts in the next class. Let's discuss about Indian languages, Indian clothing, Indian foods, etc. in the next classes. Okay. So prepare well for your exams and be confident in attending your exams. Okay, so do your best and score good marks in your exams. Okay, children, all the best for your exams. So stay happy. Okay, we'll meet you in the next class. Till then, bye.